Hello, so in this session, I'll be explaining the colony characteristics and culture techniques. So till now, we have seen different types of culture media, the nutritional requirement for the growth of bacteria. Now we are going to study how the microorganisms are characterized and what are the different culture techniques. So as we know that after inoculation of microorganism onto the media, on the solid media, the microorganisms grow in the form of colony. So following characteristics can be observed on the petri plate when the microorganisms are inoculated. We can study the shape of the colony, whether it is circular, irregular, radiate or rhizoids. Then we can study the size of the colony. It can be useful to characterize the identification of the microorganism. The diameter of the representative colony may be measured, and it can be assumed that which microorganisms may be present. Then we can also study the elevation of the colony, then whether there are margins or not on the colony, whether the margins are present. If it is present, then it is intercolony or the wavy, lobate or filiform margin is present. Then we can also study the surface characteristics, whether the surface of colony is smooth or whether it is waxy, rough, or if the colony is granular, if there is a papillate or glistening is there. Then we can measure the size of colony in the millimeter. Texture can be measured, whether the colonies are dried, moist, mucoid, brittle, viscous or buttery. We can also study the color of colony, whether the colonies which are observed, whether they are colorless, pink, black, reddish, bluish green, or if it is having a colorless, then whether there is any black pigmentation is there in the center of the colony, that can be observed. This is one of the example on the inoculation of microorganism on Meconcis agar. We can find that the Enterobacter cloacis on the Meconcis agar shows pink colony. Apart from that, E. coli on the Meconcis agar also shows pink colony. As we know that Meconcis media, it is selective for gram negative. Because of presence of bile salt in the Meconcis agar or Meconcis media, it will prevent the growth of gram positive bacteria. That's why it is selective for gram negative. And apart from that, it is differentiated for lactose fermenting and lactose non-fermenting bacteria. If the bacteria has ability to ferment lactose, then specifically the coliform bacteria like E. coli, which has ability to secrete acid and gases. So when the acids are secreted, if the bacteria are present like E. coli or the coliform bacteria is present, it will secrete the acid and the pH of the media will get reduced below 6.8. At the Meconcis media contains the natural neutral red color, red indicator. Below 6.8 pH, it will show a reddish coloration, or it changes to reddish or pinkish color. That's why it will show pink colony. But if the bacteria are non-lactose fermenting, in this case, the color of the medium will not change, and that's why it will show colorless colony. So this is one of the again examples, the Staphylococcus aureus, which is inoculated on the petri plate. It will show the result like this. Then Streptococcus pyogenes, here we can see the colony characteristics. In Staphylococcus aureus, we can see that a discrete colonies are observed. This is the Bacillus subtilis culture, and this is the Proteus. In liquid media, we will observe the growth in different as compared to solid media. In liquid media, we observe the growth in the form of turbidity. Likewise, in solid media, we observe the growth of microorganism in the form of colony. So in liquid media, we can identify whether the microorganisms are present or absent, whether they are present in abundant number or the moderate number. Presence of turbidity will give an idea that microorganisms is present. Then these are the different culture methods can be used to study the microorganism. The indications for culture are to isolate the bacteria in pure culture. Suppose we have a mixed culture and we want to isolate a particular microorganism from that mixed culture. Then we can use different culture methods in order to isolate the microorganism. Then to demonstrate the properties, we can use different culture methods. To obtain the sufficient growth for the preparation of antigens and for other tests. Suppose we have the microorganisms which are less in number, so we can grow them in sufficient number for further testing. Then for bacteriophages and bacteriocins susceptibility, we can use different culture techniques. To determine the sensitivity to antibiotics, we can use culture methods. To determine the total viable count in the samples, we can use culture techniques. And to maintain or to preserve the culture, we can use different culture methods. So we are going to study the culture methods, how we can isolate the microorganism, how we can preserve the microorganisms by using different culture methods. So different isolation techniques can be used in order to study microorganisms present in the sample. As we know that in the nature, the microorganisms are mixed, means we cannot say that a particular sample contains only one class of microorganism or only one species of microorganism. So it might contain different species of microorganisms. And for sample testing, in the monograph, there might be given that particular class of microorganism should be completely absent. So in such a case, we should get an idea whether we can isolate that microorganisms or not. If that microorganisms is present, then we can interpret the result that microorganisms or this type of microorganisms are present in that sample. So identification relies on isolating the individual colonies. So testing require pure cultures. In order to study the microorganisms, we require pure culture. We cannot study the microorganisms in the mixed culture. We cannot study the sample in the mixed culture. For example, if you want to study the water sample, then water may contain different class of microorganisms, different species of microorganisms. So whether the coliform bacteria is present in the water or not, in order to study that, we need different culture techniques in order to study the presence of coliform bacteria. As a result, the isolation technique provides an essential microbial tools. The culture methods include strip plate technique, lawn technique, or it can be also called as spread plate technique, the stroke culture, step culture, pore plate culture, liquid culture, the anaerobic culture methods can be used. See, first isolation technique is a strip plate technique, or it is also called as strip plate isolation culture methods. So in this method, the original inoculum containing mixture of bacteria is spread into four quadrants on solid media. And the goal is to reduce the number of bacteria in subsequent quadrant. The colonies are the masses of offspring from the individual cells, therefore tricking attempt to separate individual cells. And the discrete colony from the individual cells are separated and then they multiply to form isolated colonies in later quadrant. So in this method, what we do, we can use either platinum wire or nichrome wire, and one full culture of specimen can be transported onto the surface of petri plate containing nutrient media or nutrient agar. Then we go on spreading that specimen or full culture with the help of nichrome wire loop in a four quadrant. The inoculum is then distributed thinly over the plate by streaking. On inoculation, the separate colonies are on incubation, the separate colonies are obtained over the last series of streak. So this is how we can go on streaking the microorganism on the petri plate containing nutrient agar media. So this is the first method. This is called a zigzag technique. So in this, what we do, we transfer the microorganism at one place and we go on continuously streaking the sample or the culture with the help of Nichrome-Wire loop in zigzag manner. Then this is quadrant method, where we can transfer the microorganism at one place and go on streaking by using different quadrants. So this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, this is the third quadrant, and this is the fourth quadrant. This is also one of the technique where we go on streaking in the quadrant methods, and the result which we obtain is like this. So in the first quadrant, the number of bacteria are crowded. Number of colonies which we obtain are very crowded. We cannot isolate this microorganism. Then in second quadrant, the number of colonies will go on decreasing. In third quadrant, it will have few colonies. And the last quadrant, we hardly get one or two colonies which can be easily isolated. So this is one of the example where the microorganisms are streaked on the Mekonkes media. Obviously, it is a gram-negative bacteria which is grown on the Mekonkes media. As we can see here, on the first quadrant, we cannot identify a single colony. The colonies are very crowded. On the second quadrant, the number of colonies are lessened. On the third colony, we get few colonies than second quadrant. And the last quadrant, we can easily isolate the colonies. We can see here, this is a single colony. With the help of Nichrome-Wire loop, we can take out this colony and we can subculture it in another nutrient medium which will grow this microorganism. So this is how we can isolate the pure culture from the mixed culture. This is again example of the Staphylococcus aureus, and this in this petri plate you can see the Nichrome the first quadrant has a number of bacteria, large number of colonies are there. Second quadrant, the number of colonies are less. In third quadrant, few colonies are observed. And the last quadrant, we can identify a single colony. And we can scrap out this colony with the help of Nichrome-Wire loop. And we can transfer this colony into another nutrient media in order to grow the pure culture of Staphylococcus aureus. So in this, while streaking, one measure has to be taken, that try to cover as much area as possible in order to separate the colonies to maximum extent. Then second method is lawn culture. In this, we provide a uniform surface growth on the bacterium, it can be used for bacteriophage typing. It can be also used for antibiotic sensitivity test. It can be used for in the preparation of bacterial antigen and vaccines. The lawn cultures are prepared by flooding the surface of plate with the liquid suspension of bacterium. So the procedure is very simple. In the petri plate, transfer the microorganisms at the center. Then with the help of the glass rod or hockey stick or glass rod, spread this culture throughout the petri plate. We observe the growth of microorganisms like this. So we can observe the microorganisms in the lawn form. So this is the example of antibiotic sensitivity testing. So what we do here, take a petri plate, transfer the microorganism at the center, then spread it evenly throughout the petri plate, then keep the antibiotic disc at distant place and allow the incubation of microorganism. The antibiotic from the disc will diffuse into the nutrient media, and based on the sensitivity of the antibiotic to that microorganisms, the zone of inhibition can be observed. So from this result, we can say that this microorganism is much sensitive to this antibiotic. It is less sensitive to this antibiotic. That's why the zone of inhibition for this antibiotic is very less, and it is very high for this antibiotic. So next is stroke culture. It can be also known as the slant culture or slope culture. In this method, what we do, this is the slant, and we go on streaking the microorganisms in zigzag manner on the slant. So this technique is used to preserve the culture for longer period of time. The next is tap culture. It can be done by puncturing the suitable medium of gelatin or glucose agar with the long straight charged wire. So in this method, the nichrome wire, it is immersed into the culture, and it is deeply inserted into the media. This technique specifically used for the isolation of anaerobic or aerobic bacteria. Next one is pore plate culture. So in this, agar medium is melted and cooled to 45 degrees Celsius, and 1 ml of inoculum is added into molten agar, and these are mixed well and poured into the sterile petri plate. Then these are allow it to settle down and incubated at 37 degrees Celsius. The colonies will be distributed throughout the depth of the medium. And next is serial dilution technique or serial dilution method. So it can be used with the plate count method to measure the number of bacteria. Now this method is more quantitative as compared to other methods. In other method, we can just estimate that the microorganisms are present in the sample. But in order to quantify the number of microorganisms present in the sample, we require serial dilution technique. So in this technique, what we do, we take a number of test tube containing nutrient broth, then we go on diluting that nutrient broth with inoculum. So suppose we have a 10 ml of samples, 1 ml of that sample it is transferred into first nutrient broth. Each test tube will contain 9 ml of nutrient broth. So 1 ml of inoculum in first test tube will make it to 10 ml. Then again take out 1 ml of sample from the first test tube and transfer into the second test tube containing 9 ml of nutrient broth. So it will cover up to 10 ml. Then again go on adding the 1 ml of sample into subsequent test tube. Then transfer the 1 ml of sample from each test tube to petri plate. Okay, and then the count, the total number of colonies which are grown on that petri plate. Suppose we observe the one colony in 1 ml of this test tube. So one colony in 1 ml is from the 10 ml of this test tube. That means the total 10 colonies forming units are present in the fifth test tube. The 10 colony forming unit in fifth test tube is from the 1 ml of the fourth test tube. So total 100 colony forming units are present in fourth test tube. Likewise, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, and the original sample contain 10 lakh colony forming unit in the 10 ml of sample. So this is, we can go on counting the number of microorganisms present in the sample.